نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. اللهم اقسم لنا من خشيتك ما تحول به بيننا وبين معاصيك ومن طاعتك ما تبلغنا به جنتك ومن اليقين ما تهون به علينا مصائب الدنيا. اللهم متعنا بأسماعنا وأبصارنا وقواتنا ما أحييتنا واجعله الوارث منا. اللهم لا تجعل مصيبتنا في ديننا ولا تجعل الدنيا أكبر همنا ولا مبلغ علمنا. اللهم اجعل ثأرنا على من ظلمنا ونصرنا على من عادانا ولا تسلط علينا من لا يرحمنا. وبعد. Today is Friday and today's date is the 22nd of Shawwal for the year 1436 of the Hijra of the migration of our great beloved Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alayhi wa sallam, which coincides with the 7th of August for the year 2015. Today in Khutbah al-Jum'ah, we reminded ourselves about al-Hajj, about the obligation, the farida, the fard, the wajib of al-Hajj. And we quoted the verses from the book of Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala and the statements, the ahadith of Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alayhi wa sallam, to illustrate, to prove that Hajj is a must, it's an obligation, it's one of the five pillars of Islam. It is equal to ashhadu an la ilaha illallah in importance, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, equal to as-salah, equal to as-siyam, equal to az-zakah. And it is not a matter of choice. Shall I make Hajj? Shall I not make Hajj? Shall I make it now? Shall I make it after 10 years? I wait until I'm 77. No. Allah Azza wa Jalla said what? وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. It's due to Allah from people. The people owe Allah to make Hajj. From anyone who is what? Able to do so. And we said what? Once you are able, it becomes what? Obligatory. And do not kid yourself. And we said the ability is, if you are Muslim, male or female, adult and mature, you have, mashallah, good health, you have safe way, you can get there, and you have the financial, halal financial means that supports you while you are there and your family behind you. Now, the reward of al-Hajj is so great. The reward of making Hajj is so great. But before we mention the reward for Hajj and the greatness of the reward for Hajj and the great generosity of Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have to mention that first, this reward only for those who make Hajj sincerely for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have no goal, no aim, no purpose except to please who? Allah al-Karim, for the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it is not because it's the tradition, it's a cultural thing. Everybody's going to Hajj, we have to go Hajj, we live in a neighborhood, it is shame if you are old and you not make Hajj. This is the only purpose, this is the only purpose. I do not want anyone to point fingers at me. And of course, it is not so the people who can call you as Hajj or Haji, to earn a title of a prestige. It's not there. And of course, this reward is reserved for those who make the Hajj to the best of their ability according to the Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa ala alayhi wa sallam, Rasulullah. And of course, for those who did not use haram earnings to make Hajj. Steal and make Hajj doesn't work. Rob people and make Hajj doesn't work. Err from interest and make Hajj doesn't work. Selling liquor, adultery, pornography, cheating on your taxes, lying and this and that. This is haram money. The poet, he put it this way. وَإِذَا حَجَجْتَ بِمَالٍ أَصْلُهُ سُحُوتُهُ أَصْلُهُ مُسُحُوتُ أَصْلُهُ حَرَامٍ فَمَا حَجَجْتَ وَلَكِنْ حَجَّتِ الْعِيرُ. If you made Hajj from a money, look what he said. That originally, it is original source, not anymore, but original source was from haram. Then you did not make Hajj. What made Hajj is your camel. At that time, they used to make Hajj on what? On the camel. لا يقبل الله إلا كل طيبة وليس كل من حج فهو مبرور. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not accept except what? The good spending. إن الله طيب لا يقبل إلا طيبة. Not everyone who goes to Hajj, he becomes what? Back righteous. And of course, it is for the one while in Hajj, do not disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do not say, do not have profanity, do not engage in any sexual relationship with their spouses, and of course, for those who do not keep arguing arguing with the people for any little thing, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. A reminder always we say, for those who are making Hajj, please, you have to understand that Hajj is jihad. It's a struggle, it is tough, it is not easy. So you have to be patient, you have to leave your anger and your temper in your freezer before you leave, and you have to control your what? Your temper, otherwise, you are going to lose it before you leave the airport. It is tough. It is tough. That's why it is jihad. And look at this hadith. I'm reading from Sunan al-Tirmidhi. And this is in Sunan al-Nisa'i. And the hadith, of course, is hadithun sahih. The chain of narration is Hassan. An Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu qal, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تابعوا بين الحج والعمرة فإنهما ينفيان الفقر والذنوب كما ينفي الكير خبث الحديد والذهب والفضة وليس للحجة المبرورة ثواب إلا الجنة. الله narrated Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu that the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa ala alayhi wa sallam said, alternate between Hajj and Umrah. You made this year Hajj, you can afford it next year what? Umrah. Umrah, Hajj, Hajj, Umrah, Hajj. For those two, Hajj and Umrah, remove poverty and sins. Because Shaitan is going to tell you what? You're going to spend so much money, you're going to be poor. Shaitanu ya'idukum al-faqr. Allah says in the Quran al-Kareem, Shaitan promises you what? Poverty. But going to Disneyland, fine. Buying ice cream, spending $80 on ice cream, that is fine. Giving $5 a week to al-masjid, let me think about it, if I can afford it or not. Who is working you? Who is working you? Al-Shaytan. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said what? Alternating between Hajj and Umrah removes poverty and sins. Just as a blacksmith blouse removes impurities, from iron, gold, and silver. And there is no reward for al-hajj al-mabrur, the righteous hajj. The righteous hajj. Except al-jannah. Except al-jannah. Next hadith. I'm reading from Sahih al-Bukhari. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم يقول من حج لله ما في سبب آخر ما في غاية أخرى من حج لله فلم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته أمه صحيح البخاري وريد on the authority of Abu Huraira radiyallahu anhu, who said, I heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam saying, whoever performs hajj for Allah's sake, for no other purpose except what? For Allah's sake. And does not have sexual relations with his wife, or talking immodestly of vanity, or disobedience, sinning, then he will return from his, he will return free from sin as on the day his mother bore him, gave birth to him. See, where the Muslims believe what? We are born clean, free of sins. Opposite to other religions like Christians, they believe in something called the original sin. What is the original sin? Adam and Eve, they sinned. And because they sinned, all of these children are born what? Sin. And they are responsible for the sin of their what? A million years father. A million years father. Yani, if you go to a court of law, why I am here? I said, well, you know your seventh great father, great great father. Yeah, he killed someone. So, this is like 300 years ago. Yeah, but you are the great 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 grandson. So we're going to what? Execute you. Send you to jail. For life. Why? Because of you, the sin of, or the murder of what? Of your grandfather. Nobody will accept that. But ya akhwa, religion without reasoning is insanity. Just title anything religion, and people will what? Will prescribe into it. So, this is the purpose of going to Hajj. We are going there to shed our sins. So the question is it worth it to behave when you are in Hajj? Is it worth it to be sincere while in Hajj? It's just a few days. Especially those among us who go for 2 weeks. Wallahi, it's worth it. Wallahi, it is worth it. You come back and you are totally free of sin. Free of sin, unconditional forgiving. Say, well, what about if his sin is this or his sin is that? Any sin. The day as you were born. Isn't that amazing? Isn't that amazing? Next hadith. I'm still reading in Sahih al-Bukhari. عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم قال العمرة إلى العمرة كفارة لما بينهما والحج المبرور ليس له جزاء إلا الجنة الله أكبر On the authority of Abu Huraira رضي الله عنه that the Prophet sallallahu that the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam said the performance of Umrah is an expiation for sins committed between it and the previous Umrah. See the structure of the hadith. See as well, not everybody can make Hajj every year or as often as Umrah, but Umrah is more available, more affordable. So you make Umrah for the sake of Allah, and you make Umrah again, all the sins will be what? Omitted, forgiven by Allah Al-Karim Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. So please do not come back with more, with more sins. Watch your eyes, watch your tongue, and a million times watch your tongue, watch your tongue, watch your tongue, watch your tongue, watch your tongues, watch your ears, watch your hands, do as much as ibadah there, do as much as helping there, do as much as charity there, because you do not know when you are going to have another chance. Then what, Ya Rasulullah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, and the reward for Hajjun Mabrur, righteous Hajj, the one accepted by Allah, is nothing except Al-Jannah. Nothing except Al-Jannah. Something that we always remind, we should remind ourselves about. Yes, it is not obligatory. Hajj is not obligatory, except upon those who can afford it. And now I'm talking about financial means. It is not Hajj. Hajj is not obligatory in them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told them, okay, it is not obligatory. And they do not have to make it. This is clear cut. But poor people, less having, I do not want to use the word fortunate, because if it's rude, who do not have as much, you know that they long to make Hajj. Yes, it is not obligatory. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward those who are sincere in their intention. The reward may be better than those or some of those who make Hajj. Correct? But they like it. Yes, I cannot afford meat, but if I get some, alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. So, but I cannot afford it, so it's going to give me some meat. Those who can afford it, those who can spare some. To the point, ya akhwa, that Hajj, the person who does, yes, it's not obligatory, but a person who does not have the money can apply to get Hajj from Zakah money. Who said so? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Can't get it. But listen to this hadith. Listen to this hadith. If you help someone to make Hajj, you are sitting in your house and your money is working for you. Good investment. What does that mean? He's making the Hajj, you are making him happy, he's getting the reward, and guess what? You are getting the reward for Hajj and for the reward of making him happy. And making a Muslim happy the right way, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam was asked, "Ma ahabbu al-a'mal ila Allah?" What are the most beloved deeds to Allah al-Karim subhanahu wa ta'ala? قَالَ إِدْخَالُ السُّرُورِ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ الْمُسْلِمِ. He said what? Introducing pleasure, happiness, joys to the heart of the Muslim. You are eating every day meat. Your neighbor, maybe he dreams about meat. Just imagine you give him some and he's happy. Allah, this is the most beloved. تُطْعِمْهُ خُبْزًا أَوْ تَقْضِي عَنْ هُدَيْنَا. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to feed him some bread or to pay his what? Debt. Just imagine the reward. These are the most beloved deeds to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Making a Muslim what? Happy. So making a Muslim sad, what's going to earn you? Yeah? من عادى لي وليا فقد آذنته بالحرب. Anyone who has enmity to any of my allies, then I, Allah, declares what? War against what? Him. Never ever hurt the feelings of a Muslim who prostrate to Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not let the looks, the appearance fool you. Stay to the wall. Stay away from harming any Muslim. Because you do not know what this Muslim has with Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So do not fight with Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. So listen to this hadith. This hadith originally in al-Sahihain with a different text. And this is the text of Imam Ibn Khuzaymah, Sahih Ibn Abi Khuzaymah. And this hadith is amazing, although some people never heard of it, although in this masjid, I'm sure that all of you know about it. And Zayd ibn Khalid al-Juhani radiyallahu anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sallam. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من جهز غازية. I'm going to read the text of Imam ibn Khuzaymah and al-Bukhari and Muslim all together. Okay? قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم من جهز غازيا في سبيل الله. أو جهز حاجا أو خلفه في أهله بخير أو فطر صائما كان له مثل أجورهم من غير أن ينتقص من أجورهم شيء. الله أكبر. From the authority of Khalid al-Juhani, may Allah be pleased with him, who said, the Prophet, the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم said, he who equips a ghazi, a soldier in the way of Allah, في سبيل الله. He is defending Islam and the Muslims. Or he who equips a hajj, a performer of hajj. What else? Or looks well after his family. Or looks well after his family. First, a person who does not have the means, I'll give him the means. Another person, he has the means. But if he goes to go Hajj, if he has little kids, may have special needs kids, blah, 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 and there is no one to take care of his family. And said, okay, 2 weeks, I'll take care of them. Just go. Don't worry. See? Or provides food for a fasting person to break his fast, he will have a reward like theirs without diminishing any of their reward. This is good investment, passive investor. Give someone your money, sitting at home at the end of the month, unless you are jumpy, crazy about what's going to happen to the money, at the end of the month, here's a check for your profits. Here's a check for your profits. So, this is the best investment. When your money is invested with who? With Allah al-Kareem subhanahu wa ta'ala. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه. Quick reminder, we still have about 7 days left of Shawwal. And you know that fasting this 6 days of Shawwal is considered as if you are fasting. You fast Ramadan, you fast 6 days from Shawwal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you a reward as if what you have fasted the whole year. So please, if you are fasting, continue fasting. If you not start and you have the intention to fast, please start as soon as possible. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لكم فاستغفروه. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. The class is over. You can do as you wish, as you please. But if you have any questions, we can entertain them in the remaining time. Inshallah. Where is my date? My tamar, my kajur.
What's considered sick
not
to go to Hajj? I'm just curious.
What's considered sick?
I don't think I'm sick. I'm fine. Don't think about me.
See, there is difference between sick and mobility. And some people, I made Hajj with some people. They are paralyzed from the waist down. But they were in wheelchairs and mashallah, but I mean they are rich and this and that. So the accommodation was made. Sick, that means you cannot do it. Going there is going to kill you or make you what? Much worse. Okay? You cannot. Other than that, I do not know how to define it. And this is different from one person to another. A person who has a flu and he's, oh, I cannot do anything. And sincerely, he cannot do anything. And some people, mashallah, I can't tough it. Yeah? I'll tell you this true story. We had a kidney doctor from Bangladesh. He brought his aging mother to Raleigh, North Carolina, or what, I don't know I was there at that time. Maybe Columbia, South Carolina. And she got sick. He took her to the hospital, and they told her that she has cancer, and she has such number of days or weeks to live. And she told him, I'm going to Umrah now. Get me out of the hospital. He told her, but you are sick. Told him, what? Because I am sick. Because I'm dying, I want to go to Umrah. He started asking, she was telling him, I'm telling you because I am sick, I want to go where? To Umrah. I told him, he looking at me, told him, yeah, because she is sick. She wants to go where? To Umrah. They are telling you, she is dying. Yeah, he's a child. He wants to care about his mother, but some people are just, MashaAllah, tough, so I don't know, but the general rule, sick and making Hajj is going to make it worse for you, or kill you, you are not allowed. Is it? It's like fasting Ramadan. Yes?
Sheikh, generally you are not allowed to get into arguments and stuff, but if you see someone doing something wrong, can you politely
you're
asking, stop doing that?
Or? But that's not arguing, Habibi, that's advising.
It starts an argument.
When it starts an argument, turn your back and run.
Yeah.
See, I'm very sorry for being so nice. It's my fault of my parents that they gave birth to me.
And generally, it's what is that, when we say Hajj, what is the exactly time frame that we have to abide by these rules?
See it again?
Generally people think that as soon as they land in Saudi Arabia, they are in that time period where they have to abide by that rule.
Which rule? Which rule?
All this arguing and all other things.
Actually, it's before that. That's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجِّ فَمَنْ فَرَضَ فِيهِنَّ الْحَجِّ. Once you embark the journey in this month, okay, Shawwal is here, yeah, this is the month of Hajj, I have to start behaving. That's it?
It's the start of Hajj month.
Yeah?
It's Like start of month of Hajj.
Start of your declaration that said, I'm making the Hajj, all the intention, all the preparation, all the going, way before you enter into the state of Ihram. Or way before you arrive at the Miqat. Yeah? Because sometimes it's too late. You already broke every laws. Yeah? You know, Dr. Omar Hussam told us a story. They were riding with some people in the Hajj, and some of these people, they do not watch their with their mouths, and they are talking nonsense, profanity and this. And when he advised them, he said, oh, we did not arrive to Al-Miqat yet. We are still, like it is allowed to be nasty. Well, because being nasty is haram at all times. But once you are now about to make Hajj, you impose it in yourself, now you have to be careful. Yeah? And Allah knows best. Yes, Akhwan. And now I want the kids to pay attention to me. Everybody, kids, if you are a kid, except those who came late, you are not listening to the class. You were chatting, chanting, whatever it is, and you were distracting the others. And please, 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 pay attention next time. Okay? Okay, inshallah? Huh? Okay, inshallah. Jazakumullah khair. Done? Ya Allah.